Hi everyone, welcome to my video and my garden, although this is a windy and dull day. But what better there is to brighten up a day than the arrival of a new orchid? This box is large, but only one orchid inside, apart from a few supplies. Let's get straight to it and see what orchid we have in the box. Almost there. And there she is. And now, can you already guess what this is? Let's see the tag. There you go. Mystery solved. Angrecum bossri. This is a smaller variety of Angrecum sesquipedale. I've been wanting a sesquipedale for a very long time, but I never found one that I liked because I was expecting too much. I was waiting for a flowering size one, and they are not easy to come by. So I thought I'd better start somewhere, otherwise I may never get one. So when my local orchid nursery phoned me letting me know they had just received a few, I did not want to miss this opportunity, and there she is. This is a young plant, although I don't know how young. Well, she has nice long leaves and at least a nice new growing root. She is potted in cocoa chips, which look very dry. Angrecum bossri is a variety of the Angrecum sesquipedale, the classic Darwin orchid. Apparently, this bossri variety of Angrecum sesquipedale comes from a different region of Madagascar, and only in 1973 it was identified. The traditional Angrecum sesquipedale had been described 150 years earlier, in 1822. This variety bossri is more compact and can bloom twice a year rather than only once. Outside of these differences, they are the same with the same large blooms, as far as I heard. The blooms are gorgeous, and they have a very, very long and narrow spur, which can go up to 35 centimeters long. It has been a mystery for a very long time which pollinator would be able to reach the nectar at the bottom of the spur, as that was the only way to pollinate the flowers. Turns out the pollinator was taken to be Xanthopan morgani predicta, despite the fact that it had not been observed to visit Angrecum sesquipedale flowers for a very long time, not until 1992. That is when observations were made of the moth feeding on the flower of this orchid and transferring its pollen from one plant to another. There was a video made in the wild in 2004, and this is confirmed with studies in captivity. The moth approaches the flower to ascertain by the scent whether or not this is the correct orchid species. Then the moth backs up over a foot and unrolls its proboscis, the tongue, then flies forward, inserting it into the orchid's spur. Very interesting. This moss exclusively pollinates this Madagascar orchid. That is why she's so particular in finding the right flower. Now, I must say I'm nuts about plant strategies. So, now that I own a variety of Angraecum sesquipedale, I decided to dive in. It took me some time researching, looking for that video. And I am so happy to say that I found it. After going through several articles on this species and reading about coevolution, I was successful and I'm so happy. I will leave a link in the description. So if you are interested in the subject, if plants are more than just beautiful blooms for you, I strongly recommend that you go to that link, read the short article, and watch the video made by Philip DeVries of the University of New Orleans, made in 2004. The first time that interaction of the moth and a flower of Angraecum sesquipedale was captured. I assume you would like to watch that video now, so I finish here, but there will be a part 2 in which I will be reporting this Angraecum sesquipedale bossery. In the meantime, I hope you have enjoyed it so far. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to meet you in part 2. See you there!